In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of multifidus. Multifidus. This is very deep back muscle. This is important for core movement and core stability. This is multifidus. This is basically everywhere on spines. That means this muscle is on lumbar spines, thoracic spines, and cervical spines, all the way up to cervical spines. Okay? I am going to explain its origin, insertion, function, and important anatomical connection. Okay, origin is basically lower part, relatively lower part. It's from sacrum and transverse process. Transverse process. So it's here and this. Basically all the way up to cervical spines. This is origin. Insertion is spinal process. But thing is, insertion is above origin. What does it mean? Let's say it's from this level of transverse process. This muscle goes about 2 to 4 levels above. 2 to 4 levels above. Again, let's say if one fiber originates from here, it goes 2 or 3 levels above origin. So insertion is higher than origin. Does it make sense? So it's going like this. Okay. Multifidus means many fibers. Multi means many, right? That is why it has many, many fibers. Origin is sacrum and transverse process. Insertion is spinal process, which is 2 to 4 levels above origin. Okay, multifidus is everywhere on spines, but characteristic is fiber on lumbar spines is thicker than other place. It's thicker than thoracic spines and cervical spines fibers. It makes sense because lumbar spines take a lot of stress compared to cervical spines and thoracic spines. That is why fibers of back muscle is naturally thicker than other place. You can say same thing for other muscles like erector spinae and other back muscles. So it's multifidus. Fiber around lumbar spine is thicker than other places. Now let me explain function of multifidus. I'm just showing you on right side of multifidus. Of course, there is multifidus on left side. What happens when both sides of muscle contract? That makes spine extension, core extension. Extension, this is when both sides, bilateral side contracts. Okay? What happens when one side contracts? That brings spine to side bend. Side bend. And if you look at direction of multifidus, it's like diagonal, right? Again, origin is transverse process. Insertion is spinal process. So when muscle contracts, direction of contraction is like this way, right? This direction. What kind of movement can multifidus do other than side bend? It can do rotation. But which way? This is right side multifidus. Which wave of rotation can this muscle do? This is left rotation. This is contralateral rotation. Contralateral rotation. Again, look at direction of contraction. It's going this way. This way of contraction brings core to this way. This is the other side, right? Right side of muscle brings core to left side rotation. This is opposite direction. Opposite direction means contralateral. So multifidus can do extension. This is bilateral contraction. When one side contracts, that can do side bend and contralateral rotation, the other side rotation. Now let me explain important anatomical relationship with other core muscles. This is profile view of core. This is multifidus. Multifidus. I want to add three more muscles. First one is this one. This is diaphragm. Diaphragm. Next one. This one. This is transverse abdominis. Let's say it's TA. Transverse abdominis. And last one, which you don't see from this picture, imagine there is pelvic floor. Many people believe these three muscles are connected because they are very, very deep muscle. So you can follow myofascial connection through these muscles. Okay? This logic is very famous for Pilates and yoga and other kind of body work, right? These three structures are connected. Now, you can add up multifidus. Okay, I want to give you visualization. Let's say this core unit is as can, okay? Can as a beverage, okay? Let's say when multifidus gets tight, that brings this can to this way, right? Then when this part of can gets shortened, what happens to liquid inside? Okay, this liquid needs to go to this way or this way or this way. There is more pressure for other three places, don't you think? Here, 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 and here. When this part of can get more stress, the stress needs to go to every direction. In this case, diaphragm, transverse abdominis, and pelvic floor need to take more stress, don't you think? Then let's say if pelvic floor gets more tension, now there's a lot of stress on bottom of can. Where does liquid need to go? Any direction, everywhere. So in that case, multifidus, transverse abdominis, and diaphragm need to take stress. Now let's say if everything is tight, all places is tight, now liquid is compressed, then the structure inside this place needs to take a lot of stress, maybe like lymphatic system, maybe internal organs, or maybe other myofascia. I think this is pretty good visualization about connection among these four structures. That is why adequate tension of these four muscles is very, very important. Of course, you can add up other muscles. Let's say other muscles like electrospinae. You can add up psoas or iliacus. This is just simple visualization for core connection, but I think this is very good logic. In this video, I explained basic anatomy of multifidus. I explained its origin, insertion, function and relationship with other core muscles. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.